This is Maiyesh and is busy at work. It is almost a decade and he is still holding on to his first love. Maiyesh fell in love with ceramic art while in college in India. That is, when a friend served him tea in a cup. His friend has made himself and the rest is history, as people say.
My friend introduced me from Nagaland, that guy. He took me to his professor, one, that thing. I think this guy was really inspired me, because after going there, and they served me as a tea in the handmade ceramics. And very unique, I found that pot itself very unique, tea cup is very unique. And he told me, this I made myself this one. And though I'm from Bhutan, they love, that kind of chinky eyes and all. Oh, you're from where? I said, I'm from Bhutan, actually. So, you're what for here? I came to study art in Shantiniketan. So, they reintroduced, and after that, I got impressed with that thing. And I also imagined myself, then why not I can make my own things? But I don't have anything at home, but as a ceramics.
Maiyesh said, taking up a profession that is not so common but not unknown in the country is still a challenge. Ceramic is basically pottery, a profession still looked down, but Maiyesh said someone has to make what is required every day in our lives.
Actually, it's that when I was joining that thing, when I was in second year, my parents came to visit me once, to see me actually in the college days. So my mom and my papa came to see me actually. So that time, they're making fun of me actually, My parents never say don't do this and that, but they always support me, especially my father and mom. And my teachers, Ajay Kamal, he's one of the very inspired person in my life actually. So what happened was that time, many friends came from Darjeeling, Kalimpong and all to see, we used to get together sometime in my hostel days. So my parents were teasing me, mostly all other kids used to go for study in India, abroad, to study doctor, engineer. Yeah. Look at my son, he's now just potters. He was making fun of me actually. That's a very that's very funny for me. My dad was keep on teasing me that thing. So one time I feel then I realized the thing, I traveled to Nepal one time. Then they said, what do you call in Nepali in the thing? It's a Kumali, they call it Kumar. In India also they call considered as low caste. In some part of India they never work, guy never work, male never work, only women is to work. I don't know why for the reason, but they do. And I used to, it strike me once, because why they consider low caste and why. Because after coming back from India to Bhutan, I was talking to my friends and why, is it true this and that? Yes, they say true, because I think mostly kind of society also looked down by the thing, blacksmith, those who work in the metals, even the clay work and everything like this. I think that's, for me, it's a kind of trouble I find, because it's olden days, what they do. Because for me, I don't mind working with the potters actually, because it's I think being I think it's very important to preserve culture too actually. So if everyone ignores that thing, if you want to be potters or blacksmith or something, they consider as low caste, and everyone try to avoid that, means where is our society goes then? There's no potters, nothing blacksmith. Then later on, what happens is you have to work your own, then who'll consider as a low caste? That means that. That's a very essential point actually, I found. Because being a blacksmith, being a potter, none of them know that in our society means you have to work your own. Then people has to look down that way. So it's not like that now. I think people are changing their mind, everything is coming up.
Maiyesh said it requires a lot of patience and hard work. But anyone can take up ceramic pottery as an art and also a full-time profession.
We have to start from scratch, because I training. We don't have equipment in college that much, so I used to do it all my hand labor work. So mostly I learn from my seniors, mostly then my teachers, then my friends and all that. So basic thing I learn from very scratch, because from the basic level I learn, because that's I found very important for me. Some people, like those are people are very rich, and in college days they used to pay the helper, but I never did, because I'm also from the not really wealthy family. Actually, that's that thing, problem. So what I want to also what I used to thought was, if I do learn from the scratch, that I think better is a good foundation actually for me. So we used to buy rock lila from there. It's a earthenware mostly, and I used to see that where from is getting the lila. So that's one very important I find. Then how is preparation la? So I used to go and check la. Sometimes I used to go and check there, and used to supply us clay. So I used to buy, but not ready made, but it's not very fine one la. After that again, I used to refine la. From there, I used to learn how to make an earthenware pot. That's very essential in our day-to-day life also, cookingware, and sometimes in India, some days to serve tea and this and that, etc. And for stoneware, I used to mostly cope up with the senior most, because stoneware is a little bit different than otherware, and you have own composition of clay. There are six different type of clay we mix together. And it's all they call it stoneware, and even you can go for low temperature too, but I want to focus on high temperature mostly, because it's for me it's very important actually. I mostly trust with the stoneware mostly, because I found I think my instinct was whenever I see the otherware in the whenever I travel India or Nepal or something they find roadside very cheap I found And they don't have not they're not really pleasing but skill wise very good But it's from childhood we keep on seeing that same thing That's what I feel It's common for me So then I was very interested in stoneware. Then I was to learn from my senior. Actually, there are different type of clay We have a silica, we have a dolomite, we have fire clay, ball clay, then sometimes kaolin. Even we have that thing tan clay we have. Then even I used to mix sometimes dolomite a little bit, sometimes I used to mix. But I have one clay recipe la. So I have own composition because I tried my own way la. Even from coming here, I tried to add otherware from Bhutan la. Not available in other clay is not available in Bhutan actually. But I saw last time I was traveling to Bumdeli with the art camp la. There's one museum, I saw them, they keep a small stone la. They have silica, they have feldspar SLA. They're so excitement la. But I never find in a powder formula because I'm not really capable to go and see, talk to people actually. I'm very quite shy because I don't know. I find I want to go to visitors and mining and all bit where I can find the one clay.
This time, Maiyesh and his ceramic pottery is part of the second Gaki Gatin, or the Festival of Happiness. The Gaki Gatin is a platform for entrepreneurs to showcase their business and ideas. The festival also allows and provides opportunities for customers to participate and try their hands to learn making products. And today, Maiyesh has 4 clay enthusiasts and 3 of them are young students.
I think it's a wonderful job actually. If you think nowadays it's a scenario in Bhutan, it's very different, difficult to get job actually. Whether you study master level or PhD level, that's coming that thing. But only thing is, being a student or being a youthful, I think that you are really young, very energetic. You can take up anything rather than taking other thing. I think this to start a ceramics is not really tough, I find, because you go for a small, low-level, traditional pot. Because in my time, I never heard a traditional pot in Bhutan. That's what the problem is.
Maiyesh not only shows his guest participants how a lump of earth can be made into a desired form and shape, but makes them understand the physical strength and the patience that is required. The young participants find that the shiny ceramic art is more than molding the clay and getting dirty with Mother Earth.
I think it was a very nice experience and it was fun, and I get something out of it as well because I get what I made from the pottery. I mostly came here just to have fun and to just, make some balls, do something creative. If I go on practicing, I don't think I'd do this as a profession, but I do it more as a hobby.
I felt quite excited and it was quite fun. I learned something new as well. I've been dying to learn pottery since I was 5 years old. I don't think I'll be able to see any pottery experts which teaches us and all. Because it's quite hard looking for pottery people around. It's quite creative, and then if you are impatient or something like that, you can just concentrate and everything, and you can clear your mind, and even time passes by.
For Maiyesh, working a path that is less traveled in itself is an adventure, and for almost a decade, it has been a trial and error with nature and a lot of things to learn and experiment, especially with the available raw material in the country.
Coming here to Bhutan is quite difficult, like, because I have to do from scratch. Like. In India, I can find lots of raw material. I can start straight away. Then I can get a helper, everything. Like. But Bhutan, to convey the people, like, very difficult. Like. And even to convey the youth, quite difficult. But they want to work as in the wheel. Like. But it's very interesting, very fascinating, and very like kind of meditation. But working from the scratch is very difficult. Like. People, they don't like, like mostly. Like. And for me, like, come back to Bhutan is quite difficult to, because I started from scratch actually, and mostly that luckily I was quite lucky to have ceramics, you know, like Bhutan, because mostly my teachers Ajakama and they all supported, like friends, family, anyone, like, you know, that individual they support me, it's a soft loan they gave me, because I'm sorry, because of the thing, you know, that because of some few people they really support me, like I said, like CEO. Like now, new CEO, Auchimi, and even our Nima, and all, they support Asar Furwa, Aja, they support me like financially. It's like even Lodin, they support me like interest free loan. Everyone give me like that thing.
Once the clay is made into various shapes and sizes, they're baked at high temperatures and Maiyesh, this time, has the kiln filled with pottery ready to be baked.
For me, like really, I want to open up, you know, that studio where I can find a big space. Means my dream is like that, like, because I'm always attached to the vase, because I bought up in the vase like from since my childhood, like, because it's like kind of almost like when I was in class, I don't know, class two something, like that time, like. Then we have kind of that volunteerism, and you know, initiatives and all, like that thing, like. Then art of giving and all, like, because I have always dreamed that thing, like. It could be like an open space for everyone. But though now I have to pay back some loan and so the thing, because I have to anyway have to generate income. That's why I couldn't do much nowadays, because I'm mostly focused with the like earning money a little bit here and there to pay back my loan and all. But later I found, like, you know, if it is well, you know, if my luck favors me, like if I have a big hole and something, if I make a larger studio, I think people can welcome. So we have to minimal excess charge. I have to charge a little bit because I have to pay bill and all. So that, you know, that's where we have lots of like scope line ceramics in Bhutan.
Despite the challenges that Maiyesh has to face, like finding a stable market for his products and paying back the loan that he has taken to set up his studio.
So many people are interested about my demand, but I cannot meet the demand right now because I'm also kind of experimenting. I can assure the people, because mostly I feel quite sorry, because now also for me, I feel like just beginner for me. I'm still practicing in the ceramics. So that's what people used to mean. Some people really disheartened with me too, actually, I find. Because it's coming back from India to Bhutan, like, actually, have to scratch from scratch to start, very scratch, because I have to explain lots of clay. I can assure the people, because what shape will come, what color will come, that's what I have problem right now, Mostly I'm explaining with the thing, wood ash clays, mostly natural clays I'm experimenting,
He remains positive about his pottery and plans to set up a larger space where young people could learn the art of pottery, that is just seeing a revival amid the negation in the society.